Beethoven onwards, I guess, composers were more interested in putting their own souls into the music. The whole essence of what became Romanticism was the idea that the identity of the composer would be more clearly embedded in the narrative of the music and would often kind of become a kind of protagonist or a hero or a bestricken human. And from Beethoven onwards, of course, you had famously all of the issues that he had to deal with, mainly his deafness. Music becomes a sort of embodiment of humanitarian struggle, you know, the essence of the troubled soul, whether that's a soul troubled by something very real and very tangible like deafness, or whether that's a soul simply troubled by the nature of existence and, you know, what it's all about and why have I been put here to often suffer for decades. And what's so cleansing in music like this is you feel Brahms' struggle, but it's not just him. He's sort of speaking for humanity as a whole. And yeah, riding that roller coaster is pretty cool. Also, I think our relationship is really interesting in that kind of music because we have so many different facets to our relationship. Sometimes we're totally in love with each other in total synergy, and sometimes we could not be more diametrically opposed than sort of actively seeking to undermine the other. Thanks,
Luba. Oh, thank you.
That was a ruddy delight. I've been so remiss with business because music is so much more fun. So look, if you're enjoying these, please go to the link. There's a link in the description. I know lots of you already did this before we even started the concert, so mwah to you. But there's a link to buy tickets. You can set the price of those tickets. This is never gonna be a thing of finances coming in the way. But anything you can kick in is really wonderful because this is kind of where we're at right now. You know, we haven't got 3-4 concerts a week as we used to, and so while this is unbelievably good for my soul, it's even better if it's good for my pocket as well. The other thing you can do that is totally free is subscribe. So underneath the videos on YouTube there's a red button. You don't know how much it means if you hit that button. So that's amazing. We've already over doubled our subscribers in the last few months. We have a few more until we get to 1,000, and that would be something. Be something. So that would mean a lot as well. On Facebook, you can also follow the Cats Chats and 88 Keys page. Thanks so much for tuning in. It's been lovely to share this stunning music with you, and with you as always. Thanks for everything. It's been a treat. Cheers. Night.